It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. It is your feel-good breakfast show, Expresso on SABC3. Now, we've partnered up with our friends at Vital, and we're offering you at home the chance to have your health and nutritional questions answered by Andrea in person at your own home. Now, one such VO got the opportunity to do that, and her name is Ingrid Fortuin, all the way from Plumstead here in Cape Town, and she even shared her own recipe for a sugar-free cake with Andrea. Take a look.
Sugar is highly addictive, and more people are actively trying to eliminate excess sugar from their diets. Today, Vital dietitian Andrea visits the home of Ingrid Fortuin, who can still have her cake and eat it, minus all the sugar.
What was the real motivation for baking without sugar?
That's such a good question, Andrea, and I need to ask you if you can spot me in this picture.
Well, I recognize a smile here, but not the body. Is this you?
That is me.
Oh my word, what a huge transformation. You must have lost lots of weight.
Well, I lost between about 15 and 20 kilos, Andrea, and that was through finding alternatives to sugar and making sure that the family also follows the same pattern.
So you're living proof of the difference you can make to your life if you cut out sugar. But I can't wait. I have to see how one bakes a sugar-free cake.
On its own, sugar contains no nutrients or health benefits other than being easily digested calories for energy. Too much sugar can increase bad cholesterol and even cause problems in the liver.
What I see here looks like normal ingredients for a cake. So tell me, where do we use alternative ingredients?
The only alternative here, Andrea, is that we're using slightly healthier ingredients. We're using gluten-free flour and an alternative to normal sugar, which is agave crystals.
I would like to see how to put this recipe together now.
So how we're going to start is we're going to crack the eggs into the mixer and add the sugar. The mixer will kind of blend and aerate the eggs and the sugar together, and we'll slowly add in the oil. And while that's going, we'll sift the flour, the baking powder, and the salt, and we'll leave it in the bowl.
Now, how do you get your quantities right with substituting the gluten-free flour and the agave crystals?
I actually just play with it. So even if I'm making the recipe like two or three times until I get it right. But it's normally playing and seeing how the flavor comes out. And then you'll find your next cake maybe needs a little bit more syrup. So you use then a little bit more syrup because it either needs to be a bit darker, it needs to be lighter. So now our egg mixture, our sugar mixture, and the oil is ready. And we're going to slowly spoon in and hand mix the flour into the mixture.
Well, the agave crystals are great because already using less of them, but also they are low glycemic index sweetener. And also with the flours, I mean, the gluten-free flours normally consist of a variety of grains, so already you're adding a lot more nutrition into the recipe. So I see with this recipe you use the agave crystals, but you also have some of the agave syrup. How would you know with sugar-free baking which of these ingredients to use when?
Well, it depends what the recipe calls for, Andrea, because what I'd normally do is when it requires white sugar, I would use the agave crystals. When it's required to use brown sugar, I'd use the agave syrup alternative.
Can't use a heavy hand with this. This is really sweet.
So, Andrea, what we're left to do now is just pop a piece of wax paper in our spring tin. And we'll pour the mixture in. The oven has been heated at 180 degrees and we'll pop the cake in there.
Let's take a look at the scrumptious recipe one more time. Preheat the oven to 180 degrees Celsius. Beat the eggs and sugar together in a mixer and add the oil. Sift the dry ingredients together in a separate bowl and slowly add to the wet mixture, stirring by hand. Add the agave syrup and vanilla essence and mix until smooth. Pour the mixture into a lined cake tin and bake for 40 minutes or until the cake is cooked through and a tasting skewer comes out clean. Once baked, serve on a beautiful dish and enjoy.
Ingrid, I'm really impressed. I mean, you're so proactive, experimenting with your sugar-free baking, showing us how easy it is. But for the viewers, if you want this delicious recipe, simply SMS the keyword VITAL to 33728 and you'll get the shopping list and a link to this delicious recipe.
A moment on the lips doesn't mean a lifetime on the hips when you're baking sugar-free.
Make abuse a thing of the past. Nominate an organization that fights abuse so they can win 35,000 Rand from the Vital Awards.